FOODTUBE! John Quilter, aka the Food Busker, and I've got the most amazing ribeye steak for you now. And we're gonna do it with a coffee and shallot butter. It's so good. It sits in the fridge. You can just take a slice and drop it on. It's so tasty. But what's really cool about this video is we're gonna show you the perfect beer to go with that dish, because we've hooked up with There's a Beer for That, and they're great at matching the right beer with the right dish. So, let's get the butter rocking. Right, the first flavor that I wanna get is I wanna get some smokiness going. So shallots and jalapenos, we're gonna char them on the gas stove. Essentially what you're doing is what you do on a barbecue, but this is like flavor gold going on right there. You're gonna taste it later in the butter and it's gonna complement the ribeye perfectly. You want that charriness that's going on. Okay, now let's prep the garlic. So just take the heel off and then we're just going to cut through nice and thin. I'm just gonna add just a little bit of salt and a little bit of oil. This is gonna help me break it down into a puree. And then what you do is with the back of your knife, you just drag. What happens is that salt that's in there works as an abrasive and it helps to start breaking down the garlic. There you go, there it is. That's your garlic puree done. So once you've darkened the outside of everything, just take them off, put them into a bowl, and now we're gonna cling film that and set it aside for 20 minutes. Now we're gonna get the herbs ready. So you want a good heaped tablespoon of thyme and of rosemary. Pulling off the leaves and discarding the stalks. Rattle through that lot. Here's our shallots and jalapenos from earlier. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna pull the skin off and we're gonna take the seeds out as well. The reason you put the cling film on is that as the heat comes up, it hits the top of the cling film, is reflected back down, and that creates a wet heat, a steam, that then helps steam off the skins. I'm just going to roughly chop up the shallots and the jalapenos. Okay, you need about a tablespoon of oil into a hot pan, and then we're gonna get our garlic and introduce that straight in. And then I'm gonna get my fresh herbs and get that in as well. And what you're doing is you're just beginning to take some of the bitterness out of them. Let's get the rest of our ingredients in, which is the jalapenos and the shallots. And then finally, the coffee. I've got about a tablespoon of espresso here. You can use the coffee that you make from your cafetiere, but make sure it's nice and strong. Let's get it in. Literally want it on there for 10 seconds and then take it off. All those ingredients have sucked in that coffee flavor and the heat has evaporated the moisture. So now you've just got this beautiful, smoky coffee flavor in there. You're gonna put that into the butter, it's gonna be delicious. So that's dropped down in temperature, and what I've got is 250 grams of butter that I've left out, so it's now become malleable. We're now gonna add that to the rest of the ingredients. That's thoroughly mixed. Now I'm just gonna clean my hands and we'll roll it into a pack of butter. Now we're just gonna add a little bit of salt and pepper, and now I'm gonna roll that into some grease proof. Twist one way and then the other, nice and tight to go in the fridge to firm up. What we're gonna do is we're just going to oil the ribeye ever so slightly and massage it in. With my clean hand, I'm just gonna put some beautiful sea salt on there. Let's get that on. Wash my hands and then we're gonna whack it in the pan. You'd never cook a ribeye rare because that wouldn't give the opportunity of the fat that's always in a ribeye to caramelize and to crisp up. So always cook your ribeyes medium rare or up. For this size of steak, it's quite thick. I reckon it needs about 2.5, 3 minutes on either side. Now you'll notice as soon as it went in, it started smoking and having that beautiful sizzle sound. That's because the pan is screaming hot. That's absolutely key when you're doing a steak. Make sure it's blinding hot. Right, now the temptation when cooking something like this is you prod it and you move it. Don't. Have faith, leave it there. The reason that you do that is that you get these beautiful score marks. Okay, that's been 3 minutes either side. Now I'm gonna just pick it up and just let it sit on its side to just sear that off. Now look how much activity is going on there. That's why you mustn't over oil your pan or your steak. I'm gonna take it off the heat and set it aside to rest for 3 minutes. Now let's talk about the beer that's gonna go with this ribeye. I've chosen some amazing Abbey beers, which are similar to a Trappist style. If you wanna know more about Trappist style beer, then click on the link to the Craft Beer Boys on DrinksTube. These beers are full bodied and rich. They match the flavors that are in the ribeye, really strong flavors like bitter chocolate, plum, caramel. It's got a real sort of deep vibe to them. The other great thing about this beer is the carbonation and the bitterness resets your palate, gets it nice and fresh so you can crack on with your next bite. I can't wait. Right, let's get the butter. So we'll just take a nice slice through and drop him on. Beautiful watercress, gorgeous sweet potato chips. I've got some beautiful examples of Abbey beers that are gonna be so good with that. This one's delicious because it's got a decent level of carbonation that's really gonna clean and refresh your palate, and then it's got some nice fruity vibes that will go well with the steak. This one's great because it's really creamy and that contrasts with the flavors that are going on in the dish, but it's also got a hint of spiciness. And then this one's great because it mirrors all the flavors that are going on in the dish. So it's got the roasty vibe, it's got the bitter chocolate, it's got the coffee. It's the one I'm gonna go for. Wow, that is so good. Let's get a slice of the steak. Get a little bit of the butter. I'm getting that bitter coffee vibe and then the sweetness of the shallots. But I needed to have that sip of beer at the beginning to put it on top of that, like layering those flavors. Now let's just have another one so the flavors can mix together in my mouth. They just get on so well together. They're like best mates. They're just like talking to each other about the same flavors that are in there. That sort of bitterness that's in there with the coffee, it's in here as well. It's so good and they work so well together. You've got to try this. Now that was my match with this dish, but what would you have matched it with? Remember, there's no rules with matching beer with food. It's what you like. But tell me about your choices. What's your favorite beer and your favorite dish? Let me know in the comment box below. And make sure if you want to know more about beer matching, click on the link. And also, subscribe to DrinksTube, people. See ya.